Today, new things, new tech. We've already put a 4K UHD Vizio TV as our main monitor on our main PC, but can we make it work on a Mac? Let's find out. I'm Scott Drudge for New Things New Tech. In a previous video, I wanted to see if I could replace all of my old 1080p monitors with a 40-inch Vizio 4K Ultra High Def HDR TV. If you haven't seen that video, check out the link above. The short answer is yes, it works great. I'll explain what some of this means as we go along, and I'll try not to get too deep in all the technical details.
Disclaimer. Just so you know, this video is not sponsored by any TV manufacturer or anyone else at this time. All products reviewed and tested are bought by me to test and use. But hey, if some manufacturer wants to send me some stuff to review, I'm all for it. I'll still be unbiased in my reviews and testing. I'm not a fanboy of any particular brand. I currently have Samsung and LG TVs in both HD and UHD, and have played with many different brands. However, I do look at all the specs and at the stores to find out which TVs offer the best image before purchasing. End of disclaimer.
Today, I want to see if I can do the same thing with the Mac, use a 40-inch Vizio 4K TV as the main monitor, and do away with the really old 1080p HDMI monitor. Really, any semi-decent 4K TV should work. If nothing else, the video should appear a bit better on any newer TV monitor, and even a 4K monitor at less than UHD should still look better. The Vizio V-Series TVs that I've found work really well, are cheap, have great clarity, color, and more. 40 to 43 inches is the sweet spot as a computer monitor for me based upon my desk space and how close I am to the TV. Specifically, I'm going to try adding the Vizio 4K TV to this old 2012 Mac Mini. This Mac Mini should be able to support 4K from what I've read. First, I'll try the stock HDMI port out on the Mac and see if that works. Next, I'll try the Mini DP to HDMI adapter that I bought and see if that works better than the internal HDMI adapter. The 40-inch Vizio TV is the 2019 model, V405-G9. It has three HDMI ports. Port 1 has an audio return channel and supports HDMI 2.0. I do, however, doubt that this Mac Mini from 2012 will be capable of HDR video or even a full 4K. My PC's GTX 970 video card does support HDR, full 4K at 60Hz, and looks great with HDR content. Port 2 on the Vizio TV is an HDMI 2.0 with no audio return channel, and port 3 is HDMI 1.4. It also has composite for hooking up some of those older school games, VCRs, and more. Keep in mind, this is part of the specs for the 2019 Vizio 405G9 that I'm using for this review and test. I put together this little chart, which I'll have posted up on the New Things New Tech site. So how do you find out when Vizio made a particular TV? Well, unfortunately, it's almost impossible to find out. The manufacturer does not indicate this information exactly, but this can be derived from the model number. Vizio starts creating new TVs in the third quarter of any given year and assigns the labeling of the next year. So in this example, the V-Series listed here with a year indicator of H indicates that most likely came out in late 2020 and may continue through 2021. At the time of this recording, January of 2021, there does not appear to be a 2021 year designator assigned yet. So the example shown is a V405H9, which is the latest V-Series model for 2020 to 2021. Basically, all this means is look at the model number of the TV size you want, check several selling sources to see the full model name, and the higher the letter will indicate the latest year of the model. So let's get this connected and see if we can get it configured to run the 4K TV as well as my PC does. All right, so I have the Mac Mini fired up and connected to the monitor it's normally hooked up to. This is an old Acer monitor with a DVI input. The HDMI out of the Mac Mini is converted to DVI to connect to the monitor. This monitor has a native resolution of 1680 by 1050 and what the Mac is running at on this monitor. The screen is a matte finish. It may be hard to see the quality on YouTube, but from my perspective, it looks pretty good. So I'll go ahead and run some video and see how that looks. I'll use a 4K HDR video found on YouTube, but run at an HD resolution for this monitor. Anytime an HDR monitor is detected, YouTube will normally auto-switch the video to HDR if it's available. This is a random TV demo HDR 4K video I found on YouTube. It plays pretty well, downscaled to 1680 by 1050. You can see the HD settings down here and the resolution that was chosen. Next, I'll do a quick test of the DisplayPort to HDMI adapter to see how well it works on the 1080p monitor. Bringing up the same demo video, running the 1080p 60 HD video still looks pretty good. Notice that it's HD and will not show the HDR version of this video. Let's switch it over to the Vizio TV now and see if the Mac can recognize the 4K TV. First, we'll try the internal HDMI connector. Checking the Vizio info bar, you can see that it recognizes this as a 1080p signal. The image quality on this display looks good to my eyes, much brighter and cleaner. Probably hard for you to tell on this compressed YouTube video. I'd expect that since the video is now 1080p, being upscaled to the 4K display, it's going to look better anyway. So now we need to see if we can get a 4K setting in the system preferences and display settings. It's set to 1080p. Checking in the scaling option, it doesn't appear to support anything but 1080p or 1080i. So the internal HDMI connector doesn't seem to be able to go higher than 1080p. Could it just be that this 2012 Mac Mini doesn't support higher resolutions? So next I'll try the DisplayPort to the HDMI adapter and see what we can get from that. Just to be sure, we're testing clean, I rebooted the Mac Mini. Back in the system preferences, looking at the display settings, still doesn't look like anything greater than 1080p is available. I kind of expected this, as Mac Mini by default may not be able to enable higher resolutions, and based upon what I've read in various threads. However, there is a piece of software you can get that may unlock higher settings. SwitchResX claims to be able to get you quickly the higher resolution options you want. You can get a trial version which is fully functional for 10 days. After that, you need to pay $16 for the app. SwitchResX isn't an App Store product you can install. You need to either download the trial version from either the developer site or from another site like CNET. Once downloaded and installed, SwitchResX will be found in the system preferences. The program requires a daemon to run in background to get the highest number of resolution options. Supposedly, this is a very lightweight program and doesn't use much system resources. So on the list, there can be found what appears to be higher resolutions than 1920 by 1080 that were only found in the display settings. Switching to one of these settings, it does appear to get, say, 4K 2160 by 3480p at 60Hz. However, in checking the Vizio bar, the TV is still only receiving a 1080p signal. I did try several different configurations, settings, bouncing back and forth between the internal HDMI port and the DisplayPort 4K HDMI adapter, but was never able to get a true 4K signal out. The SwitchResX program really only appears to be doing some sizing magic and shrinking the screens to appear 4K or other resolution when it's really still only a 1080p signal. This seems pretty evident as the image quality gets worse once bumped up to a different, higher setting. Based upon that, I wouldn't recommend getting this program. The Mac display settings, if the monitor is properly supported by the graphics card, should give you the correct options to change resolutions and be able to get 4K. It's still possible I'm missing some setting in the program or the Mac that might get you 4K on an older Mac Mini, but that doesn't seem to be the case with this Mac Mini from 2012. Note that most Macs from, say, 2016 forward should have no problem with 4K displays. I just didn't have a newer Mac to test with. In fact, the old Power Mac that I have doesn't have a graphic card in it able to run 4K display. It's just a beefy, overkill, power-hungry machine that sits in a closet and creates a lot of heat. This Ronkeam Mini DisplayPort to HDMI supports 4K and is a good, cheap cable that can be used to add a second monitor or a mirror to your desktop. So can you use a 4K monitor as your main monitor on a Mac? Absolutely. Even on this old Mac Mini, the video looks really clean when compared to the old Acer 22-inch monitor. Thanks for watching New Things, New Tech. I'm Scott Drudge.